really didn't understand and say. We say things out of anger, but it's all love because we wanted the best for my dad. And I want to say to my aunt, my aunt Bob, I'm sorry and I love you. And I know you only wanted the best for your brother, and I wanted the best for my dad. And that's not some of the arguments and things that I said should have been said. It was said out of anger. It was said because I'm a spoiled. And at the end of the day, you know, you step up to the plate and you know you're wrong. And I've been wrong. I've been wrong about a lot of things. I've been right about a lot of things. I've been wrong about the things I said to my family members in arguments. I've also been right about the decisions that I made for my father as a business decision. And I've also been right about the way I was brought up by my mother, my sisters, and my brothers. They taught me right from wrong since I was little. So some of the things that I've done, I know that it's been wrong. And I want to say in front of all my friends and family, I'm sorry. I'm not perfect. I'm never going to be perfect. And that's just the way it is. And once you don't like it, oh well. So, at the end of the day, I have no regret. Amen. About my father, we've had some long, drawn out fights. Things I said to my dad, I should have said. He probably said some things to me that he should have said. But at the end of the day, life goes on, and that's the way it is. I still love my father. I don't take nothing from him. I'm glad and I'm proud to be a Spalding man. Because my dad did something that the average man don't do in this world today. They don't step up to the plate. And from my understanding and the stories and the things that my brothers and sisters have instilled in me, that he was a great man. No matter if their father was there or not, I only can go by what the stories that were told to me. But I've never heard anything negative about my father from my brothers and sisters that he's done wrong. So on that note, he gets an A+ in my book, far from being a man. Spalding, and I hope that I can continue to be a Spalding man and carry on his name, and that my boys will do the same. And if they don't, then they got to deal with me. And one last thing I'd like to say on the program, I didn't acknowledge his other half, and that's because I was angry. I was very angry. Really, really angry. So I want to say that I'm sorry. I let the anger overtake me. And that shouldn't have happened. And that he does have another half. I am going to know him, Turk. Her name is Irma Spalding. Even though she didn't do the things that she should have done, but at the end of the day, I believe she loved my father. But whatever regrets and things that happened along the way, I'm not going to say that she didn't love him. I'm going to say that she didn't. I can't speak for her, but I'm going to acknowledge that she was as far as your mom is going to belong with. And I know we all hurting. It really hurts me probably the most, because I've been with my dad from thick and thin, state hospitals and hospitals. But I tell you, some of the stuff that he went through, I couldn't have did it. Maybe got me out a long time ago, 2 shots to needles. But he did it. And I'm proud of him. I should have came to Kentucky sooner. And I'm sorry, Bob. That was something that I have to live with. I should have got on the plane when you told me to. And I didn't.
No, but I'm okay
with it. I'm alright. I'm not crying because he's gone. I'm crying
because
Joel. He ain't got to suffer no more.
Amen.
He ain't got a point. He ain't got a cuss.
You know he's a cussing bandit.
Hey, dude, you can.
So I'm crying because I'm happy that he finally got his wish. I'm not a
a religious person. I know right from wrong. Whether he goes to heaven or whatever heaven may be, because I don't know. So I can't give you a scripture for something that I don't know. But I do know whatever angels or whatever it may be there, he's gone. Because my father touched a lot of hearts. He was the jokester of the family. You know, no matter what, my dad was always there for everything. Even when he was sick and he had heart attacks and strokes, because of money, you know, me and him had many arguments about you. many arguments. But at the end of the day, he said, nope, he's falling. I'm on my way. And I respect that. I respect everything that my dad has ever done. So my tears are for happiness and joy. Because he's okay now. And I accepted that. I'm okay with it. I cried my cries because of the pain, but my cries now are for joy. Wherever it may be or wherever he may go, I don't know. Maybe one day I will know as I continue my search for my beliefs and my religion. I only can go by what my mother has instilled in me. I can't give everybody scriptures because I don't know them. Everybody has their different beliefs, but I respect everybody's religion. Whether you're Catholic, Jehovah's Witness, Baptist, Yahweh, you know, we see them all. I respect everyone's religion. And I respect what everyone has to say. So at this time, I want to say thank you. Especially to my Aunt Bob, I want to thank you for everything that you've done. My sister Terry, she's going back and forth up there. I just want to thank my sister Trish, my aunts, my uncles, my brothers, everyone who's always been there for my dad, especially my sisters, because when I was wrong, they was on me. They was on me. Woo! That's awesome. My friends. But I love my sisters. One thing about my sisters, and they're just like my mother, they don't cut no cards. And if you wrong, you wrong. And they gonna tell you wrong. And my sister Terry, she's the first one to tell you. She gonna tell you wrong. I love her to death. My sister Trish, she's the oldest. You don't even just talk to her. You don't even say nothing. She say you just... We're nervy, eh? We know. Your best shot is this. We know the end result. Angie, I love my sister Angie. She's quiet. She's a push-up. We just love her to death. And my brother Reggie, I love him to death. And Reggie sends his love. You know he couldn't be here, but we know how our other brother is. We love him to death, though. To my wife, I'm sorry. We've been through a lot. I've said some things along the way, and I apologize to you just as well. I apologize to my daughter. She wanted the best for dad, and I said some things to her, and she wanted the best for her grandfather, and I snapped at her. Same thing with you, son. I love my children. I only wanted the best for my dad, Shay Shay. I apologize to you. We've had some words. I love you. We only wanted the best for dad. And I'm a man today to stand up here. And I don't do this often. I take my last and keep on going. But what makes me a man, a Spalding man, is that I can stand up in front of people. It doesn't matter. If I can stand up in front of a crowd of 20 and 30,000 people, then I can stand up in front of my family and say, I'm sorry.
Amen.
So I just wanted to tell you that, not only because it's my dad, it's because I love you guys. I'm sorry.
We love you too.
Anyone that I may feel through this time, we only wanted the best for dad, and I'm sorry. Now, I'm gonna be okay. I want this to be a happy, joyful occasion, and And I thought I had to do this alone, but I didn't. My sisters and my brothers were here. They walked me through the whole process, even though I'm almost maimed. But thank you. I thank each one of my brothers and sisters for helping, guiding, and strength. Even though I was being a prick, my sisters, they didn't yell at me like they wanted to. They still let me know who the boss is, and I respect that. And I always respect that, just like I respect my aunts. You my aunts, you just Paul and Queen. You always gonna be our queen. That's the way it go. I'm here for you. Just because he's gone, he's not forgotten. And our family will never be forgotten. And for my cousins, thank you. It's gonna be hard for a couple of days, but we're gonna get through this as a family. I've been getting through it. He's okay.
Mm-hmm.
He's okay now. And I'm okay with that. I'm okay with it, just like I was okay with my mom. Huh? Yeah. We'll be okay with everything. Whether I see him again or not, because I don't know. And I hope one day I will know. As I continue my journey and my quest to struggle with my different religions. And that's okay with me too. For people who don't like it, oh well. That's 6'3", 5'5". Say it's okay. But thank you. I want to thank my Aunt Wanda. She's always been there for us and our family through our troubles and times. My Aunt Wanda called me up anytime, and she gives me words and wisdom. And I want to say thank you, Aunt Wanda. I want to thank you when I called one day. I didn't know Aunt Wanda was at the hospital. And I called and said, hey, Aunt Wanda's here. Aunt Wanda's here. And she was set up there with Dad. And one time, Dad had pulled all his tubes out. Remember that thing, Bobby? He pulled all his tubes out. Everything. And one thing that he can get out of his mouth to Aunt Wanda was food. He wanted food. So, thank you.